Hey guys, we are in the basement, and today we're gonna do a John's Arcade on the road. That is right, guys. Yes, we're gonna get in the car, and guess what though? This one was inspired by a viewer mail. That is right, a viewer mail is giving us direction for this episode. Let me read this viewer mail to you, and let's see where we're going. What are we gonna do in this episode? All right, so I got a viewer mail here from Austin LaPlante. That's right, Austin LaPlante. And Austin says, "Hi John, I've been a subscriber since the Journey Restore, and I have also seen all of your other recent video uploads and restores. I've always wondered if you have been to the Pinball Wizard in Pelham, New Hampshire. Pelham, New Hampshire. If so, are you able to record there? I've always liked that place since my grandmother told me about this about a year or two ago. They have so many pinball games. I hope you read this. Austin LaPlante. P.S. How are you doing with the 720s monitor?" Don't read this, P.S. if you read this email during that 720 restore video. Well, Austin, actually, I have been to the Pinball Wizard Arcade in Pelham, New Hampshire. I'm familiar with it. I actually know the owner of the place. I've met her a few times, Sarah St. John. She actually helps out with ACAM at Funspot, and I've met her a bunch of times. And yes, I've been there. I know all about it. You know what? Why don't we go there? I got some time. Let's take a ride up there. And what's great about this place, too, guys, keep in mind, if you're planning a trip out here to go to Funspot, because I know a lot of guys are planning little vacations and stuff to go to Funspot. This place is about an hour south of Funspot, so if you're like coming from Boston, you can stop at this place on the way. So anyway, Pinball Wizard Arcade, Pelham, New Hampshire. Yes, I agree, let's go. It's a pretty cool place too, and they got a lot of pins, let me tell you, a ton of pins, and a lot of great vids too. Anyway, enough of that, let's get in the car and let's take a ride to Pelham, New Hampshire and check out the Pinball Wizard Arcade. Guys, we're in New Hampshire, Pelham, New Hampshire, and we're coming up to the Pin Wizard Arcade here on the right. I guess it's actually Pinball Wizard Arcade. I haven't been here in a while. I'm kind of looking forward to seeing what's different. This place definitely has a killer collection of pins, though. I mean, if you're into pinball, this is definitely a pretty good place to be. So it's right in here. It's in this little strip mall, and there's a sign, Pinball Wizard Arcade.
In 0.2 miles, arrive at address 150, on right.
So, all right, I'm gonna park, and let's go inside and see what's going on. All right, guys, we're here. Pinball Wizard Arcade, Pelham, New Hampshire. Let's go in and see what's going on with this place. And again, you know, I haven't been here in a couple years. The person who owns this, Sarah St. John, she's a big time collector. She actually helps out with ACAM, so I know her from there. I don't think she's here today though. And but let's just go in and we're just gonna walk through here. I brought my tripod. Yes, I already came in here. And I thought it would be actually great if we walked through the arcade with the tripod. And the first thing we're gonna do though is we're gonna, and by the way, pretty sick, right?
Look at all the pinball machines. Come on. Ridiculous, right? All right, so we need to get some tokens because I have a bad habit of not having tokens when we walk through these places. So we're gonna play some games, guys. So, should we get $5 worth? Yeah, let's get five. We'll start with $5. You excited? Oh, come on. There we go. All right, so let's walk around. And so they got a price counter here. So we're gonna just take our time and talk about every single game. So this is a glove boxer, never seen that before. Arm Champs 2, we saw that at Galloping Ghosts, and was that at Royce's Arcade in California? All right, so here's the new Stern. This is the 1965, the 2015 Ford Mustang Stern pin. That looks pretty great. Here's a Star Trek. This is like the deluxe one, the LE. Another new Stern. I like the topper. I like that kind of chrome little shroud around the DMD. Tron Legacy, James Cameron Avatar. Avatar's cool because it has like a lenticular back glass, so you guys can see that. But the back glass is like one of those like kind of hologram things. If you look at, you know, one way, you can see it's like stuff's moving. Lord of the Rings, great Stern classic. Pirates of the Caribbean, another Stern classic. Actually a good game. Designed by Dennis Nordman, who was like a big Bally Williams guy. He did like Whitewater and stuff like that. Spider-Man. Everyone seems to like this Stern game. Steve Ritchie designed that. So a lot of Sterns represented here. Here's NASCAR. I think that's another Steve Ritchie game. Monopoly, it's a Pat Lawler game. That's actually a pretty good game. I wouldn't mind a Monopoly. Adam's Family, everybody loves Adam's Family. Maybe we'll play that later, I don't know, we'll see. We're gonna come back and play some pins. I wanna check everything out first. Twilight Zone. Circus Voltaire, man, that's a great game. For a while there, I really wanted to get a Circus Voltaire. It's cool, it has like neon in it. Look at the neon right here. That's sick. Ridiculous. That was and the DMD is actually underneath the glass. It's not in the backboard. It's back there. Isn't that wild? And that was designed by John Pompidou, who did like World Cup Soccer and Theater of Magic. I actually don't really like the guy as a designer, but this is, I think, his best game. He did Tales of the Arabian Night and all that. NBA Fast Break. I've got one of those. Love that game. Roadshow. So you can see we've got all the new Sterns and all the great classic Bally Midway Williams games. So Roadshow, Pat Lawler, what's a wide body. He's got the two heads in there, which is kind of cool. See that? They talk. I like this game. My buddy Adam has one of these. It's got like a country music theme, and I think it turns a lot of people off, but I think it's kind of cool. Funhouse, another Pat Lawler game. I like Funhouse a lot too. It's got Rudy in there, another head game. The talking head back there. You know, I think this game's awesome. It's kind of like a reverse Whirlwind, the playfield layout. I like it though. I would consider a Funhouse. You know, if I were to ever get rid of my Whirlwind, I think it would be for another Pat Lawler game, either a Funhouse or even Roadshow or Adam's Family or definitely Twilight Zone. All right, the next game here is Medieval Madness. I love this freaking game. I know that this is one of the most sought after pins right now and has been for a while. It's big bucks. These things go for $10,000-$15,000 sometimes. There's a company in Chicago that's actually reproducing these, and I would love to be able to get one of these. I just can't afford it. It's just so expensive, but I think the game is so cool. And it's got cool voice call-outs. It's got this castle in the back. Actually, you know who's in this? Is Tina Fey is in this. Because I think she was at Second City at the time. And, you know, Williams is a Chicago company. So they were using Second City talent to do the voices in the game. And Tina Fey is actually in the game. Isn't that cool? You know, of course, you know, Tina Fey from SNL and 30 Rock and all that. I love this game a lot. A lot of people do. Indiana Jones, yeah. See, this is another one I would love to get. Because I mean, Raiders of the Lost Ark is my favorite movie, I think, of all time. And this pin is so cool. This is the Williams one. Stern also made one, too. This is the one to get. And this is a wide body, too. It's cool, like the gun. Champion Pub. I like this game, too. I played it a couple times. It has, like, this boxer in the middle that turns around. It's a DMD game. You don't see those very often. Theater of Magic. I used to have that. I hate Theater of Magic. I think I'm alone, but I do. Junkyard. Actually, I like Junkyard. I played that game in a Chicago bar. It's actually pretty cool. There's a Pinbot these guys are playing. Pinbot's okay. It is definitely an iconic classic game. To me, it's a little repetitive and boring. It's cool, though. It's, you know, these older pins just don't really do it for me. Maybe it's just because I wasn't really playing pinball at this age when this game came out. I don't know what year this came out, like in probably mid-80s or something, early 80s. Yeah, it's okay. 86, yeah. It's cool, though. The Bride of Pinball, I think, is cooler, the sequel. F-14 Tomcat, another Steve Ritchie game. It's a pretty cool game. It's a fast game. It's, you know, this is kind of during that whole Top Gun thing, I think. They're kind of it has those lights on top, which is cool. Black Knight, I used to have one of those. I actually really do like Black Knight. I'm not sure if I miss mine, but as far as pins from this era, which I typically don't relate to, this is probably one of the better ones. And this one has a very nice back glass. I don't know if it's a new one or what, but it's in really nice shape. And by the way, the games in general seem to be in pretty decent shape here. Look how many pins there are. This is just ridiculous. Black Knight 2000. I don't like this game. It's okay. I know a lot of people do. I prefer the original one. This was a newer Steve Ritchie game. And I don't like the play feel. It's just too... It's not very open. I guess if you compare it side by side with the original, it's almost the same play field layout. But this top play field eats way more into the bottom one. I don't know. I just don't like it as much. It's cool, though. Now, Banzai Run. This is a game that I freaking, like, love. The last time I was here, I played this, and I could not believe how badass it was. Actually, why don't we play this really quick? By the way, my hand is bleeding. I cut myself somehow. What's cool about this game, and by the way, this is Pat Lawler's first game, and the story goes is that, like, Pat designed this in his garage or something, and he really wanted to be a pinball designer or I don't know what happened, but I guess he was on a bowling team with some of these guys, and he said, hey, I can design a pinball machine. And he designed this, and they brought it into Williams, and they made it. And the gimmick here is that it has an upper play field. See that? So there's actually a play field in the back glass, and it's a motocross theme. So it's like a motorcycle-themed game, and you get the ball up there, and then you get to play the top. And maybe we could try to play a game here. It looks like there's a credit in it, too. Let's see. I think this game is so cool, though. Like, seriously cool. I would take one of these in a heartbeat if I had an opportunity. Let's see if we can get the ball to the top.
He's going after Hillbilly.
All right, so the ball is now in the back glass there, if you guys can see that. And so I got flippers up there. And so we want to basically just make it to the top, and then, oh, I failed. But you get the idea. It's super cool, man. It really is. Just look at it. I love this. I think Pat Lawler is just awesome. Pretty sweet, right? We got one ball left here. Let's give it a go. Yeah, man, I would absolutely grab one of these. They don't come up for sale very often at all. I had an opportunity to buy one, and I should have done it. I was foolish.
Red hot.
see if we can get the ball back up there.
Nah.
The sounds are pretty good, too. Anyway, you get the idea. All right, so Williams High Speed, another Steve Ritchie game. People like this game. I mean, this is a classic game. Definitely an iconic pin. Diner, I think this pin's cool. It has these people in the back glass, and when you play the game, they kind of move around. It's pretty awesome. I've considered getting a diner. There was one for sale recently by me that I thought about, but I just can't swing it right now. Fishtails is another game I've considered. Python Angelou's got this bass on the top that like dances. It's really cool. Pretty awesome game. Whitewater, this was a game I almost bought. My buddy Riggy had one for sale and I should have bought it because it was dirt cheap. And it's really a well-respected game. It's cool. Earthshaker, we talked about that at Grinker's. It's another Pat Lawler game. That's the game that came like before Whirlwind. And another like disaster-themed pin. And then Whirlwind, of course, right next to it. So Pat Lawler did like Bonsai Run first, and then Earthshaker, and then Whirlwind. And so those are his three games right here. Gorgar. That game's actually pretty cool. I used to play that on my PSP. And then Guns N' Roses, which is actually a great Day to East game. That game's a lot of fun. William Sorcerer, I don't really think I've ever played that one. Actually, it looks pretty cool. All right, so what's over here? We got a Space Shuttle. It's okay. My buddy had one of those. It's a little simplistic for me. I know that it was a big pinball at the time, though. And it has like a little plastic Space Shuttle in it. Space Station and Blaze Blue. That's a cool fighting game. That's actually a very cool fighting game. Yeah, Blaze Blue is sick. That was on, Xbox 360? Aerosmith Revolution. This is like a gun game. Let's go down here real quick. They got a bunch of vids. So, Konami Sunset Riders. So, these are all like Dynamo style cabinets. All right, so this is how you do kits, guys. Look at this. All the right kind of cabinets. So, Sunset Riders. Karnov, is that a dedicated Data East cabinet? I think it is, yeah. It's down. Let's see, Knights of the Round. Can't say I know that. So we got a lot of these kind of side-scrolling shooting games. And then we got all of these games with the rotary joysticks, top-down shooters, POW, Prisoners of War, Victory Road. And these all have those rotary joysticks like Ikari Warriors, where you spin the joystick to aim, and then you got fire and grenade. I used to love Ikari Warriors, man. These games all kind of look like Ikari Warriors, same kind of guys. I don't know if these are sequels or what. So Guerrilla War, SNK, Sega Choplifter. Not sure what kind of cabinet that used to be. Tank is an Atari Key game, right? I think so. That's a cool black and white game. Simpsons Bowling, look at that beast of a cabinet. Kind of cool. Super Contra. Wow, that looks awesome. Is that dedicated? That thing looks sick. What cabinet is that? Is that original? Let's see. Golden Axe. Some nice looking games here. This is a rare game. Gottlieb Exterminator, man. All right, we got to try that. Let's try some Exterminator. I think I've played this before. This is rare, guys. It's 1989, Premier Technologies. I think that's when Premier bought Gottlieb or something like that. And look at the control panel. Dude, that's badass. I really like that. All right, let's give this a go. Okay, so we got one credit here. And so we got this joystick with a button on the top and then a pound button. I'm not really sure I know how to play this. All right, so we have a floor plan. Kitchen. Shake joystick to make it go away, then shoot it. Don't grab it. Wow, dude, this is weird, man. Press or hold the joystick. Press start button to begin playing. Wow, look at the graphics. All right, so this hand is like shooting at these bugs. It's kind of like a Galaga, but like first person. What is happening here? This game sucks. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just trying to shoot these bugs. So yeah, I have this pound button and the hand pounds on the ground. I don't know what's rolling towards me. What is that? Paper towels? Okay, they're cans. I see, so I'm supposed to smash the cans and kill the bugs. Where are the cans coming from? It's funny. I don't know. You get the idea.
It's not a very good game.
Alright, so over here is a dedicated Rolling Thunder. That's a cool game. I used to love Rolling Thunder. That game was so badass. It's like a side-scrolling game. It's really cool. Try that in MAME. That's a great game. Baby Pac-Man. Man, I miss mine. I always say that. Xenophobe. I used to like that game too. That game gets no love whatsoever, at all. At all. All right, so that was that row. Pretty nice selection of stuff, right? All right, so Wizard of Oz. You know, that was a big deal when it came out. My buddy Riggy had one. It's a Jersey Jack pinball machine. It's got the, you know, the big deal is the LCD in the back glass. You know, really a first for pinball, which is weird. You would have thought someone would have done it before. It's an okay game. My buddy Riggy got bored of his pretty quick, though. It's neat though. I like it. It was fun to play. All right, so Walking Dead. This is the new Stern based on the TV show, and I think people are liking this game. I have never played it. Should we try it? Yeah, let's try it real quick. See if we get an idea, a flavor for it here. Oh my God! Quarter credit. Look, I put one token in. You gotta put four tokens in to play this. Come on. Well, I guess these expensive games take a while to pay off if you don't do it that way, huh? City of Fool. Alright, so. Let's see what's going on here. So we got this big fat zombie in the middle right here. You can hit him. So there's like this like garage or something in the middle. I don't watch this show, so I don't know anything about it. Is that a hospital? And we lost the ball. I don't know, it seems kind of cool. It's got some cool toys on it. You know, you got your fat zombie right here. There's like some kind, I think, is that a hospital or a garage or a warehouse? What's going on back there? You hit the doors. Artwork's okay. This is the LE version. Numbered, like, they make like 500 of them or something. I don't know. Yeah, pretty cool. And over here we got a Transformers. Oh, dude, they have America's Most Haunted. All right, we have to try this. This is a Ben Heck game. I love Ben Heck, by the way. So Ben Heck designed this, and I guess the Spooky Pinball guys put it together. The podcasters, I guess, right? So this is Ben Heck's pinball machine. Wow, dude. All right, we gotta try this. Let's see what's going on. Four tokens. Pretty basic layout.
Is there anybody here that wants to communicate to us? The paranormal.
So right now we're selecting a skill shot. That's cool, like a door just opened up.
This hospital's haunted by the ghost of an insane doctor.
It's a class one.
It's kind of cool.
Oh, what?
Oh, that's cool. There's like an elevator back there. that's, I kind of dig it. Let's take a look at the playfield.
I sense the ball is lost.
So there's like a ghost, and then you hit the drop targets, and then they lower down. There's like a magnet in there. There's an elevator in the back. I gotta say, it's not bad. Artwork's a little okay. That's pretty cool. All right, let's go down here. Okay, so we got a bunch of fighting games, and Mortal Kombat, Mortal Kombat 2. I'm not sure if that was a X-Men or Simpsons cabinet originally. An Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, and looks like some kind of Dynamo. Mortal Kombat 4. Tekken 5, is that dedicated? That thing looks pretty badass, actually. It's nice to see the fighters well represented, though, because, you know, when I go to Funspot and do those videos, everyone always says, John, where are the fighting games? And by the way, this place is not that far from Funspot, so if you guys ever come to Funspot, you might want to consider coming down here, especially to play pinballs. Killer Instinct, like that. Marvel Super Heroes, Capcom. Lot of fighting games. Marvel vs. Capcom in a Mortal Kombat cabinet. Marvel Super Heroes in a Mortal Kombat cabinet. X-Men versus Street Fighter in some kind of Dynamo. SVC Chaos, SNK versus Capcom in Big Blue. That's, I love that cabinet. Namco Soul Edge. Man, I that's cool. I can't say I know anything about that. A Neo Geo 2 slot with Bust a Move and Bust a Move Again in it. I like that. It's in a great setup there. And then a Neo Geo 4 slot. She's got King of Fighters 98, Windjammers, Samurai Showdown 2, and The Last Blade. And over here is a Crisis Zone. That's a big boy. And then a six-player X-Men. That's freaking awesome. My buddy Adam has one of those. I love the toppers she put on there. I might have to steal that idea. So six-player X-Men is really cool because it has two monitors in there. And one's on the bottom and one's on the top. And there's a half-silver mirror, and they kind of butt up to each other. And it looks like one continuous monitor. And this cabinet is freaking monstrous, man. I mean, the control panel you could, like, live in. Then over here is a Spider-Man. That looks like a former Gauntlet cabinet. All right, let's go down this side. Darkstalkers, Capcom. That's a CPS2 game. Who was it was telling me? Oh, in the, when we went, was it Jason? In the Arcade Impossible video, he was saying that was his favorite fighting game. Check this out, Sailor Moon, man. What is going on here? It's a weird cabinet, too. Is this a fighting game or a side-scrolling game? Do we want to play some Sailor Moon? I think we should. It's hilarious. Alright, so what do? Is this like a beat-em-up game? I've never seen this. I never even knew. Oh, dude, this is awesome. it's like a double. Oh man, it's like a double dragon type game. Oh, that dude, these chicks kick ass, man. That's awesome. I gotta say, this is kind of cool. It's like a turtles type game. It looks like you can have maybe up to four players. But with these Sailor Moon chicks? All right, that's awesome. Smash TV, I love this game. Eugene Jarvis, you know, the guy that made Robotron. It's kind of a twin stick shooter, you know, but a little more advanced. And I used to love playing that game. And Total Carnage, which is the sequel, right? Which one came first? Was it Smash TV? I think so. I think Smash TV came first, and then Total Carnage. And they're awesome games. Rampage, that was a game I definitely played a lot when I was younger, and it's funny though, these days I don't really care to play it. I don't know why. WWF Superstars in some kind of Dynamo cabinet. Nice, cool wrestling game. WrestleMania. Boy, that looks pretty awesome, actually. I used to love those games. I think I played those on my Super Nintendo. And but Matt Mania, that was the wrestling game I really liked. All right, so Primal Rage. That's the dedicated cabinet. Pretty crazy. Fed has one of those, or did. Pretty nuts, right? The artwork. Alpha. Oh no! Another food fight bites the dust. Is that a food fight cabinet? Street Fighter Alpha 3 in a food fight. I guess we just cannot escape the conversions. Oh well. Alpha 3 is a good game though. I like Alpha 2 better. I love those graphics though. Here's Alpha 2 right here. I had an Alpha 3 board and I ended up settling on Alpha 2. I just kind of like it better. Here's a, oh wow, it's a Mario Brothers wide body that was converted to Street Fighter Alpha Warriors Dreams. Looks like a cool game though. I mean, it's pretty awesome that they have all these fighting games though. I would put it in a Mario Brothers. Maybe she got it like that. I don't know, that's a little strange. Here's a Turbo Hyper Fighting. I have this board at home. Some kind of dynamo cabinet. Here's a Street Fighter Champion Edition 2. That's the non-hyper fighting version. That actually, when I got my Street Fighter, it had this version in it. And then I converted it to the hyper fighting. X-Men Children of the Atom. Don't really know that, to be honest. And then Ice Cold Beer. Gotta love that. Not really a fan of the chrome T-molding. People like to put chrome T-molding on stuff. I don't know why. I never got into it. All right, let's go over here. So we got a big ass row of pins, like a ton of pins. So why don't we start on this side and then let's, okay, here's one of those little Gottlieb games. Remember we saw that at Royce's Arcade? That's a Nudget. It doesn't have flippers though. It's just, you just kind of launch the ball and it just kind of comes down like pachinko. Here's a Tapper. Now, interesting, I noticed it had a Root Beer Tapper PCB in it. So it's a Tapper cabinet with Root Beer Tapper board. Cabinet's in pretty decent shape. Bally Midway Crater Raider. Okay, we are playing this. You know what? There was one of these on eBay very recently, and it was in California. And it kind of got me excited because it's an MCR game and I never played it and it just seemed really cool. And what's cool about it is it has this concave, if you guys can see that, it has a concave, like half silvered mirror in it. So it makes the picture kind of look like it's all rounded. Let's play this. And it's MCR, you know, same as Tapper and Tron and Timber and all that. That's the hardware class. And so we got this joystick up and down, we got buttons on it, and then we have a spinner knob to turn. So let's see how this plays. Pretty weird looking game, man. Oh, listen, it sounds just like this in Tron. Oh man, this is kind of cool. Do I fall in those holes or no? Oh, I gotta rescue people? Oh, this is kinda cool, man. I don't know, man. I kinda dig it. This guy totally dig it. I can get behind that. Sorry, man. I like that. All right, Terminator 2, Judgment Day. Boy, that game is loud. Upscope, Grand Products. I see those for sale all the time on Craigslist. Area 51, Maximum Force. What is this? Midway Invasion. Wow, dude. Looks like it's down, though, but it looks like a cool gun game. Big Buck Hunter. 2005 Golden Tee. It's kind of interesting to see a Golden Tee in the middle of a... what is going on here, man? SNK Beast Brothers? Busters? Boy, that looks pretty badass. This cabinet is awesome. Okay, what is this game? Alright, we gotta definitely try this. Turn the light off. So these guns are kind of like Operation Wolf, because SNK made Operation Wolf, right? This town is doomed. Those who enter never return. All right, let's try this out. So is this kind of like a zombie Operation Wolf type game? Aw, man, the gun doesn't work. Aw, bummer. Something tells me it's kind of like an Operation Wolf type game, but with zombies. Carn Evil. That game keeps getting talked about lately. Blitz 99, that's a gun game. It's like an evil carnival theme. Blitz 99, some kind of dynamo cabinet. Blitz, I actually really like Blitz and NBA Jam. I actually almost bought a Blitz. I went and actually, there was one on Craigslist. I actually went to the guy's house with my friends and I just bailed on it. I just kind of chickened out and didn't buy it. It was probably a good move, but I almost bought a Blitz. And Blitz typically, I think, has a Nintendo 64 card slot on it. Because I think you could play the game at home and then go to the arcade and bring your stats. Wayne Gretzky's 3D Hockey, I actually really do like that game. I think I played that on the 64. Was that on the 64? I think it was. All right, so what is this thing? T-Mech. Wow, man, she's got some cool shit here. Atari T-Mech. Look at that, man. That is cool. It's like some kind of tank game. Wow, I dig that. Maybe we'll come back and play that. All right, let's go down this row here. So we have a Simpsons four-player. All right, here's a Superman. That was Steve Ritchie's first game. He worked at Atari and then like quit, and then that game came out. Cyclone, Williams' game with Python Angelou artwork. Maverick the movie. Isn't that funny? I mean, that's a movie that just kind of no one remembers, right? That movie just came and went, and here's the pinball, still alive. I wonder if it's any good. It's crazy. All right, so the hook. And by the way, the last time we did hook, I like looked at Peter Pan. I said, oh, Robin Williams played Peter Pan? I don't remember. I'm like, is that Robin Williams? No, I think Robin Williams is Peter Pan. I still don't know. I've never seen the movie. Tales from the Crypt. That was a cool show. Cool pin, Data East. Data East was really big on the licenses. You know, they did Pinball Wizard, which was that was based on like the Broadway Who play. Tommy. Strikes to Spares, kind of a cool, interesting Gottlieb pinball machine. We should actually try this. I like weird stuff like this. Let's keep the light on here. So three tokens for one play. So it's like a bowling game, but it's pinball. Please select. All right, here we go. It's pretty wild, right? So it's pinball, but you're playing a game of bowling, and you use the flippers to throw the ball down the lane. Boy, this would probably get old quick if you had one of these in your house. Kind of neat though. No Fear, another Steve Ritchie game. Williams. Blackwater, this game's actually pretty cool. I played this, and what's cool about it is all the plastics in here. The ramps are all like vacuum formed. You know, this is kind of like Banzai Run, but Bally's version of it. But it's got really cool ramps. It's actually a lot of fun. I played one of these recently and had a good time with it. Star Trek The Next Generation, that was another Steve Ritchie game. There's been a bunch of Star Trek games. I think this one's considered the best of them all. And I do like it. It's a wide body. It's okay. I'm not a Star Trek guy. Here's the Data East one. I remember seeing that in Las Vegas. Bad Cats. I've played this game a couple times. It's actually not bad. Riverboat Gambler. Can't say I've ever played that or seen that one. I think I've seen it and never played it. Looks kind of cool. Bally Who Done It. My buddy Riggy had one of those. It's okay. It's kind of like a murder mystery type game. Judge Dredd. We saw one of those at Scoots. Now look at that. So that's what the Dead World looks like without the mod. Interesting. And Scoots had the Dead World mod, if you guys remember. And of course, that's based on the comic book, not the stupid Sylvester Stallone movie. No Good Gophers. I used to have this game. Love this game. It is a fun game. It was just too much like Whirlwind for my taste, so I got rid of it. But it's a good game. Bram Stoker's Dracula. My buddy Brian has one of these. It's pretty fun. Doctor Who. It's a Bally game. It's okay. Creature from the Black Lagoon. World Cup Soccer. Now, this is a game I actually really want. And I'm going to try to get one of these in 2015. We'll see what happens. I think this is a good game for me. They're fairly inexpensive, and it's a good game. It's based on the 94 World Cup, and that little dog was their mascot. I actually like the dog. I think that would look good next to my NBA Fast Break, right? All right, so Black Rose. That's a pretty cool game. It's a pirate thing. People complain about that thing down the center, how it's all in the way. There's like a lane here. The ball drops down and falls on the flipper. Mousing around. Pretty cool. Belly's Party Zone. Dr. Dude. That's not a bad game. I've played that a few times. Bally Pool Sharks. Don't think I've ever played that one. And then we have Transporter the Rescue. That thing's crazy. Look at the artwork, man. Look at that. That's ridiculous. And then Mario Mushroom World. I used to have this pinball machine. Now, right now, the legs are set at the lowest setting, so it's kind of like super low, but you can raise them up so it's a normal height. And I had mine set that way, where it was the same height as the other pins. It's an okay game. It's cute. It's a novelty. It wasn't bad. I didn't hate it. It just wasn't a super deep pinball, and I did get rid of it. I regret it a little bit because it's pretty rare. They only made like 500 of those, and it's just a short, cute little pinball machine. Look at that. All right, so let's go over here. So Flintstones Memory Match. Pac-Man Cabaret. So we got more pins down here, you can see. Oh, this is kind of cool. It's head-to-head pinball, football game. Boy, that's really cool. So she's got one of the newer four-player versus Pac-Mans right here. It's awesome. All right, so Pac-Man Cabaret, pretty decent shape. So more pins, Williams Firepower 2, Firepower 2. Here's Firepower. We played that at Scoots yesterday. Williams Scorpion. So there's some older pins here that I cannot relate to. It's a wide body right there. So Kiss. I seem to remember playing that when I was a kid. I mean, Kiss was pretty amazing when I was young.
TV.
Yeah. Silver Ball.
What is this for?
It's just for my YouTube channel.
Oh.
8 Ball Deluxe.
Which is what?
John's Arcade.
John's Arcade.
Yeah. Bally 8 Ball. Kind of controversial because it had Fonz on the back glass, but it wasn't Fonz. They didn't pay to have Fonz on the back glass. Regarded as a pretty great game. Embryon, wow, dude, that game's crazy. It's a wide body. Look at that artwork, dude. That is nuts. That's crazy. Bally Paragon, I've heard a lot of people talk about Bally Paragon. You know, this stuff's just before my time, and I'm sure it's great, but I cannot relate to it at all. But it does look pretty sick, man. I mean, look at this back glass. What is going on here? All right, Revenge from Mars. We have one of those in the basement. Great Pinball 2000 game. Star Wars Episode 1, regarded as not as good as Revenge from Mars. But another Pinball 2000. That was the last game that Bally Williams made before they shut down the pinball division. And it's quite a shame, but it's okay. This is the Data East Star Wars game. Kind of cool. I wonder if Stern will make a Star Wars game. How much you want to bet they do with the new Star Wars movie coming out? Popeye Saves the World, Saves the Earth, rather. This was a Python Angelou game. It's kind of weird, crazy game. It's like a cruise ship. It's like a Noah's Ark cruise ship type thing or something. South Park. It's actually not a bad game. It's a Sega game, you know, based on the TV show. This is the Data East Simpsons. Not as good as Simpsons Pinball Party. Now, Simpsons Pinball Party is freaking awesome. This one's okay. It's got the same pop bumpers in there, same tooling. Because Data East, I think, kind of morphed into Stern in one way or another. Because Gary Stern was working at Data East. And then they kind of made their own company. All right, so Gottlieb Cue Ball Wizard. There's lots of
billiards and poker themed pinball machines. As we learned when we went to Las Vegas Pinball Hall of Fame, Stargate, that's based on the movie. That game's actually not bad. I played that at Richie Knuckles. I kind of enjoyed it. Rescue 911. That game has like a helicopter in it. Yeah, back there that kind of moves and grabs the ball or something. Now here's a Super Mario. This is the full-size Gottlieb Mario Brothers pinball machine. I would consider getting one of these. Ah, it's out of order. I've thought about getting one of these several times, and I really feel like I should, but I don't know if it's a good game. I'm worried it sucks. But, eh. Gottlieb's Panthera 2. Boy, that's kind of cool. Never seen that before. Some pretty sexy imagery going on right here. Williams Flash. That was a Steve Ritchie game, right? I think it was the first game to have flashers in it. Gottlieb's Genie, we saw that at Scoots. Space Invaders, I love the artwork on this. They pretty much ripped off Giger and made it look just like aliens, but they didn't get permission to do that. And because that's supposed to be, you know, the title Space Invaders. That's not aliens. What do you mean? It looks exactly like it. Bally Xenon. Love that back glass. So cool, man. Laser Ball. Yeah, hi. So over here we have a Gauntlet Legends, which is like an updated version of Gauntlet with some pretty slick graphics, too. Looks great. All right, let's go down this row. We got a lot of classics here. Robotron 2084. Every arcade needs a Robotron. Defender. Paperboy. Gotta love. Oh, wow. It's got a LCD in it. That's kind of crazy. Yeah, medium res monitors are hard to come by. It looks really weird with an LCD in it. Qbert. You know, these people who have these arcades, man, they're up against a battle. You know, you can only find so many monitors. Qbert Cubes, man, that's freaking awesome. That's a dedicated Qbert Cubes. Yeah, I wouldn't mind having this. I don't know if I really like the game. Want to play it real quick? It's an okay game. I used to have this on the multi, and it's a really tough game. But the cabinet is, you need any tic-tac-toe to win. So we gotta basically, actually I don't remember how to, oh that's right, you turn the cubes over and you can only jump on them so many times. I forgot how to do this. Yes, when you jump off, the cube spins. It's really, I forgot how to play it. I used to know how to play this when I had it on the multi and I forgot how to do it. Because you see the cubes have purple and yellow on them, and so when you jump off, you're spinning the cube. And so if I turn that purple, and we try to get tic-tac-toe, yellow, boy, that game's tough, man. I don't remember how to play it at all. I love the artwork, though. Star Castle. That's probably Cinematronics' best well-known vector game. Midway Gorf, I've seen a lot of those. Dig Dug. I always say it, I do like that game. Ah, Arabian is cool, man. We played, did we play Arabian at 2084? We did, right? Yeah, we did. I kind of dig it, man. Burger Time. I love me some Burger Time. All right, Crystal Castles. We said in the last viewer mail that I would play a Crystal Castles the next time I see one. All right, let's give it a go. All right, so first of all, let's state the obvious. The cabinet is beautiful. The artwork is fantastic. I love the cabinet so much. It's true, okay? The gameplay is not bad. So let's give it a go. Let's give it a go. You know, I'm saying that now. Did I pick that up from the UK? let's give it a go. All right, so we got one credit here. All right, so we're the bear here, and we basically had to, it's like Pac-Man, you gotta collect all these gems, and you can jump.
And if you guys remember in King of Kong, that Mark Appleger guy with the glove, you know, this was his game. And he would play, he had a special Crystal Castles glove. All right, so we passed the first level, we got all the gems. You know, maybe I am being unfair with this game. Should I get one? All right, so we got the honey, which, what does the honey do? Jump button allows a seat game screen. What the hell does the honey do? I thought the honey would allow me to kill those guys. The game gets really confusing though, because you start walking inside like invisible rooms and stuff, and game over. Wow, I suck at it. So there you go. We played Crystal Castles. Did you guys like it? It does look damn good though, I'll give you that. All right, so Tempest. That's a upright full size Frogger. Gotta have a Frogger. Tari Millipede, kind of the sequel to Centipede. And then of course Centipede next to it. I don't like Millipede though, because it has a bigger trackball. Centipede used the smaller one, and it's just, I think, a lot quicker to play. When I play Millipede, I played on a Centipede cabinet, so I'm really used to that small trackball. All right, so we have Asteroids. Gotta have an Asteroids, and Asteroids Deluxe. I do like that she's grouping the sequels next to each other. That's cool. Blastroids, you know, that is a game I've always wanted to try, and we're gonna try that. Did I try it somewhere recently? I feel like I've played this somewhere not that long ago. But it's like a raster version of Asteroids. And I think the cabinet's kind of fun. All right, so we got a thrust and a fire. Oh, wow, you could bump into them? Yeah, see, and it's using a spinner to rotate your ship instead of buttons like the original Asteroids did. Yeah, I could get behind this. This isn't that bad. What's that thing? Oh, I can touch that, all right. What's this button do? Oh, wow. I can change into two different kinds of ships. Oh, is this ship more durable or something? What's going on here? Oh, this ship doesn't have a, oh no, it does. So now we gotta warp out of here. Oh, I see, there's three different ships. There's armor, shots, and speed. So the fat ship must be armor. Okay, so this ship's way faster, but it has lame firepower, I see. And then this ship has armor, you can just run into this stuff. And then this ship is more efficient with its weapons. Wow, that's kind of cool, man. Wow, this game is not bad at all. I don't know how it would be long term. And it looks like you can play two players simultaneous, which I think would be kind of fun. Sweet. All right, so we got a Nintendo row here. We have a Popeye, Donkey Kong Jr. with the front painted black and it's kind of down, Galaga 3, which is a great game. I think it's also called Gal Plus, is that right? And then original Galaga, which I still need to get in the basement. Miss Pac-Man Super, wow, this is crazy. So that looks like they made some kind of maybe bootleg artwork for that. Miss Pac-Man. It's signed by someone, Steve. Oh, that's probably the guy from the guy in Cambridge who made Miss Pac-Man, the mod, General Computing. Pac-Mania, I always like this game. It's got this really cool like 3D marquee, which is badass. That's a Namco System 1 cabinet. You know, Dragon Spirit had that same cabinet. It's pretty cool. And then we have an original Pac-Man right here. All right, looks like there's some kind of a party room back here. Let's go check this out. I think they have like kids' parties and stuff here. Oh yeah, look at this. Hey man, what's up?
How you doing?
Hey, you're John, right?
I'm John.
What's up? So John, what do you do here?
I'm the technician here.
You're the technician?
Yes.
So you're fixing all these games?
All the games, all the time.
Is that right?
Yep.
And so what, is there like one game that's always broken that you just, you hate?
Everything varies here.
Yeah.
It just depends on how the maintenance is kept up on them. We try to at least wax and clean up the play fields at least once a week for every single game.
Is that right? So you take the glass off and wax the play field in every game every week?
We inspect the flippers, make sure they don't need a flipper rebuild, make sure all bulbs are there.
Wow.
Make sure everything's working.
That's crazy. crazy. And so what breaks down most often? The pinball machines or the video games? Which ones are you working on more?
More pinball than video.
More pin, is that right?
Yep.
And what is it that breaks down? Like the flippers or the boards or?
They take more abuse.
They do.
Because everything, all the targets are getting hit all the time, mm-hmm. and it's gonna be constant wear on the play field. It's always going to be something with pins.
Right. And is there a pinball machine here that gets played the most? Like, when you guys are emptying the tokens out, like, is there one game that always has so much money in it?
Adam's Family.
Adam's Family. Still.
Yep.
And that's not the newest game. It's not the latest game. That game's from the 90s, and it's still making that kind of money in this room.
Yes.
That's crazy.
Yeah. We do have new pins on the floor that make pretty decent money.
Yeah.
But still the most popular one and most is Adam's Family.
Right. And that's the most produced pin ever. I mean, that is the most popular pinball of all time. So that doesn't surprise me. And so you guys have a lot of Sterns. I saw you guys have that Ben Heck spooky pinball, the America's Most Haunted. What do you think of that? That's pretty cool, right?
It's a cool game.
It is cool.
Yeah. They kept it pretty simplistic.
Yeah.
But overall, for the maintenance on it, so far it hasn't been bad.
It is. So is the build quality? What's in there? Like a computer? A PC?
It's all a computer.
It is. Arduino or?
One driver board on it.
Because Ben Heck, I think, designed the board, right? Didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Okay.
And he did the programming as well.
Has Ben Heck been here?
Not to my knowledge.
No. All right, so all these games are in this room. What is your favorite game? If you had to pick one game.
In the whole entire place?
Yes.
Banzai Run.
I love Banzai. I played that too. I love that game. I even said earlier, I want one of those. It is such a unique pinball machine.
It's hard to find, and it's a challenging game.
Does that game break often?
Not that much.
No?
No. We like I said, we try to keep up the maintenance on this stuff. If something goes down that day, we try to get it up and running within like the hour of that day at least.
Wow. So John, how long have you been doing this here?
2.5 years.
2.5 years. And how long has Pinball Wizard been open?
We've been open 4 years.
4 years. And did I already ask this, how many games? There's like 350?
About 350 games.
Wow.
104 pinballs.
Wow, dude, that's a killer collection. And this room is for what, parties? Is that what's going on?
This is our party room. We have for our party package, the kids.
And you're selling the games. Now, do you guys typically only sell the games in this room or the ones on the floor or?
It depends what we get in.
Is that right? Is this kind of the overflow room in a way?
Mostly.
Yeah.
We still have more games for sale, but this is basically what we have right now. We constantly.
So like how much would that cube or cubes, like how much would Sarah want for that?
Sarah's in charge of the pricing.
Oh, okay.
Different price on everything else. I just did the maintenance for it.
Gotcha. But I noticed that Baby Pac-Man had a price of $9.95 on it, and which is not unreasonable at retail, you know. And you guys are warranting it too, right?
Warranting it for 30 days, and it also comes recapped, new rings in the play field, new flippers, everything's been recapped.
It works 100%.
It works 100%.
As is $9.95.
Yes.
Well, maybe after Sarah sees this video and gets all kinds of views, maybe she'll work out a deal with me on that. Cool, man. All right, well, hey, John, thanks for answering those questions. And, oh, Revenge from Mars, $33.95.
Yep, that one. Yeah. I just sold that.
Oh, you just sold that?
Yep.
Not really unreasonable for retail, you know?
Nope.
I mean, those games are probably going $2,500 right now, if collector to collector. Mm-hmm. And that's with a warranty. Does that have their original computer, do you know?
It does.
It does? Awesome. All right, John. Well, hey, thanks for your time, buddy.
Not a problem.
Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you.
All right, cool. All right, guys, let's go walk around some more. All right, cool. All right, cool. So we got one more row of games to check out down here. So Max TT Superbike and Virtual 2 On, which is some crazy robot game. Didn't I see that in Hong Kong? Where was I? I feel like I've seen that before. Road Riot 4-Wheel Drive, which is a big driving Atari game. Star Wars Racer Arcade. That's like the pod racer game. It's pretty cool. Pole Position Cockpit. That makes me happy. And it's working. It's working! All right, and then we have this Addams Family Generator game with like Uncle Fester's head on the top. And Ski Ball. All right, so we got a row of classics here. We got Atari Super Sprint, which is a three-player version. Joust 2, Survival of the Fittest. Joust 2 is pretty cool. Vertical modern joust game, and looks like a dedicated one. I know you guys said that, oh, the one that was at Galloping Ghost is also dedicated. I guess there's two different kinds of side art, and one of the versions of side art is the same as Joust. All right, here's a Timber. Kind of like a sequel to Tapper. Metal Slug X, which is awesome, in a Dynamo type cabinet. Tron. Now the next game here I really like and I really want, and I really should get one of these because I just think it's cool. I like Bump and Jump. It's a game that I did play when I was younger, and I have fond memories of it. And every time I play it at Funspot, I have a good time. And I don't know, I just think it's kind of cool. You're like this car, and you press the jump button, and it kind of goes up in the air. And it's kind of like Spy Hunter, except you can jump and you gotta land on the guys to kill them. And it seems kind of simple, but it's kind of fun because the roadway gets kind of complicated, and there's like bridges and water, and I don't know. I just remember playing this like at a Showbiz Pizza and enjoying it as a kid. So I'm gonna have to jump here soon. See that little warning? The whole jumping thing like kind of blew my mind when I was younger. Missile Command, classic game. Bagman, that's a pretty cool rare game. I actually really dig Bagman. Gyrus, it's kind of down. Zaxxon, dedicated. Viper Phase 1. Raiden DX. Do Run Run. Dedicated Mappy. Oh, this is awesome, guys. Look at this. So we've got a Mach 3 here, laser game. It looks like there's an LCD. My guess is there's a computer in there. I bet you it's running Daphne with an LCD. Doesn't look bad though. Wanna try it out? This is a pretty good Laserdisc game as far as Laserdisc games go. Next to Dragon's Lair, this one's pretty tight. There was Star Fox, which is similar with the flying, but I think this one does it better. And this was a Milestar game, Milstar. All right, wanna do a fighter game? Let's do a fighter game. So it's got a flight stick, which by the way is the same as Mad Planets. My Mad Planets actually has a Mach 3. So it's funny, it's like we're flying over this background, right? But it's like they put a game over the background. So like this is computer generated, the targets are computer generated, and the background, which is Laserdisc, is really just eye candy. You're not really interacting with it at all. But it just kind of gives the illusion. It's pretty cool. Phoenix, classic game. Bunch of redemption stuff, if that's your bag. Kids probably love all this stuff. Redemption, redemption, redemption. Cruising Arcade. Man, even more games. There are a lot of games here, man. R-Type. Dedicated Circus Charlie. That's awesome. I love that game. Radical Bikers is a fun game. So we got Punch-Out and then Play Choice 10 and a Punch-Out cabinet. It's funny that the kids playing Punch-Out NES. Super Mario Brothers versus... Here's a Nintendo Super System, which is cool. Now, there's Play Choice 10, which is over there, that has basically NES games. And then they did the Super System, which has Super Nintendo games. And it's got these big controllers. And this one has Super Mario World, F-Zero, and Super Tennis. And it was literally the Super Nintendo, man, in an arcade cabinet. You know, it's one of those Nintendo games that, you know, when I set out... In the beginning, I wanted every Nintendo game, you know, and I considered getting this because I wanted every Nintendo game, but I think I would regret, I think that would get lame quick, and I don't think they made a lot of cartridges for it. I just don't think it was a very successful system, and I don't like these controllers. I like joysticks. I don't want to play with a giant D-pad. All right, Mr. Driller, that's cool, the LCD. That's a good game, though. Jungle Hunt. They made Jungle Hunt and Jungle King. Jungle King had a Tarzan theme and they got in trouble. And so they had to change the theme to Jungle Hunt, which is a guy with a pith hat instead of a Tarzan looking guy. Silkworm, I seem to remember liking that game in a Taito cabinet. Elevator Action in a Jungle King cabinet. Stun Runner, which is kind of cool. Crazy Taxi, Hydro Thunder. All right, so we didn't go down this side right here. So Track and Field in some kind of weird ass cabinet. Arch Rivals. you know, like a dynamo. Is that, that might be dedicated. I don't know. My buddy, Mark had one of those games. It's actually kind of fun. Super Cobra. I actually really dig that game, like, a lot. Now, this is Turbo Outrun, which is kind of the sequel to Outrun. And I don't think it's as good as Outrun, but it has, like, this turbo button, which is not here. This is not a dedicated one. They had, like, a... I think it was on the shifter. There was a button that you'd press. And I think on... Yeah, see on the picture there? I think on the conversions, you'd use the start button for turbo. Okay, so this is a Wacko, which is a pretty cool MCR game. And what's cool about it, of course, is this slanted cabinet. Look at that thing. It's a fun game, too. Want to play it? It's okay. It's not the best, but it's not bad. But it has some pretty unique controls. It has a roller controller, and then it has these joysticks. And this is for firing, and this is for moving. And let's give this a go. This game next to it, Atomic Punk, is interesting. It looks like Bomberman. This is a game, though, I've considered getting. So we fire with the joystick and we move with the roller, and we just basically gotta kill these guys. And that's pretty much it. I think there is some variety, though, in the later levels. This guy's... What happened to him? He's wigging out there. Oh, you gotta get them. You gotta get pairs of them. Is that what's going on here? Ah, I see. You gotta kill its twin, otherwise it won't go away. It just stays stunned. That's kind of cool. So we get the hunchback, we get the other hunchback, two-headed dragon, then the demon, and the demon. Pretty cool game. The cabinet is sick, though. I mean, it's just amazing. All right, so next to it is Atomic Punk, which looks like some kind of a Bomberman-type game. Kind of cool. Galaxian. Let's see if I can squeeze through here. Excuse me. Thanks. Marble Madness, which is an Atari System 1 game. Rockstar Black Tiger. Frontline, which is an awesome Taito game. An Arkanoid and a Q-Bert cabinet. All right, so that's... pretty much it. So we've walked through the entire place. What did you guys think? Pretty awesome. So I think I've played everything I want to play. What do you think, guys? Want to go back to the basement? Actually, he's working on the Guns N' Roses. You want to go check that out? See what he's doing? Let's see what John's doing with the Guns N' Roses. John, what's going on? You fixing it?
Yeah.
Changing some bulbs.
Bulbs, and I'm gonna redo the flippers on this.
Oh, the flippers are bad?
Yep.
This is actually not a bad game.
This is another well-played game.
Is it?
Yep.
Yeah, I mean Guns N' Roses, come on, man.
Yeah.
Not very relevant today, but they were... Axl Rose is kind of a douche now. But back then, they were... And when I was in high school, it was amazing, the music. Well, cool. All right, man. Well, hey, thanks for hanging out.
Hey, no problem.
All right, see ya. Yep.
I can't
think. All right, guys. I think we're done. Look at all these games, by the way. Just look at this. It's pretty epic, right? Walking down this row. Look at this. All right, you know what? I'm going back. We're going to do this again. Because it looks so badass in my viewfinder with all the pins. All right, here we go. Let's try it again. Because it really does look sick. Okay, you ready? All right, here we go. Look at all these games. Man, I mean, if you guys want to play pinball, and vids too, this is a pretty good place, man. Pretty good selection of stuff. I mean, compared to, you know, Funspot, it really has no pinball machines. So this place kind of has the pins covered and the classics. So I gotta say, I dig it. I mean, yeah, there's some conversions, yeah, there's some games of LCDs, but overall, man, it's a pretty great selection of games here, you gotta admit. Pretty awesome. Alright, guys, we're done. Let's go back to the basement. Did you like that? Was that fun? Did you enjoy Pinball Wizard? All right, let's get out of here. Was it better with the tripod, by the way? It's gotta be, right? This has gotta be way better than walking around handheld. I'll try to do this more often, so. All right, guys, let's get out of here. Let's go back to the basement.
Maybe I shouldn't be demanding when I ask for these little things. How could I have known that one time too many would mean the end of everything? No one can see, no one can see what will be the last straw. It may not be very heavy, but we're barely hanging on. I'll take it back, I'll do what I can. All I ask is one more last chance. One more last chance.
All right, guys, there you have it. That was the Pinball Wizard Arcade. What did you think of that place? Pretty great, right? Really? I mean, come on. If you guys like pinball, you know what's great about that place? It's got a ton of pinball machines, a ton of A-list, well-maintained, great pinball machines, but then they also have a lot of video games. They have all the essential video arcade games. Very cool place. And you know, if you're gonna go to Funspot, I really do recommend stopping there also, because it's not that far away from Funspot. I think it's about an hour south. It's like in between Boston and Funspot, so I think a lot of people fly into Boston and drive up. And if you're gonna do that, stop there. Pin Wizard Arcade, Pelham, New Hampshire. That was cool. All right, so I want to do some viewer mail. We got a bunch here. I got tons of viewer mail, guys. I mean, I have tons and tons and tons of viewer mail. So if I don't read yours, I'm sorry. Nothing personal. What I've been doing is just before I record, I go into my Gmail and I just grab a bunch and print them. I don't read them really. I skim. If it seems good, I'll just read it. So, all right. So the first, and by the way, if you guys want to send viewer mails, send them to my email, blkdog, the number 7 at gmail.com, blkdog, the number 7 at gmail.com, and important, in the subject line, please put viewer mail, otherwise, I'm not going to find it. So, all right, this one's from Top Tier Arcade. It says, hey, John, amazing channel, man. It is Steve from Top Tier Arcade, and I've been watching you for 2+ years, and you have been my inspiration ever since I started the hobby and the go-to channel to watch for help, ideas, and fun. Thanks, buddy. A few questions. When you do your on-the-road videos, it seems like you don't stay long where you visit. An example is when you went to Hong Kong, Puerto Rico, Chicago, Galloping Ghost. It seems like you leave shortly after you arrive. Do you just review the arcade and dip, or do you stay overnight and take in some sights and sounds? Number two, I know you mentioned your arcade is not open to the public, but have you ever considered a private function, a bachelor party, a corporate event, a birthday party to recoup or reinvest in your games? I've been asked this question as well, and my wife is creeped out about strange nerds in our home. What do you think about this and why? And number three, being that your second album is coming, that's right, the Kill Screens, our second CD is coming out next year. Would you ever consider having a viewer mail contest to send you cool album cover titles or song titles, and the most popular or likes would determine the album title or song title? Just thought that'd be a fun idea that would drive more traffic to your channel. I know you've been busy as of late. I was wondering if you had a chance to check out my channel, Top Tier Arcade. I would love to get some feedback. A lot of my games are focused on fighting games, which I know isn't your favorite genre. It hurt me to hear the nasty comments that were made on your Street Fighter 2 Hyper Fighting review towards you. All the best and keep up the great work, Steve Antoner. That's a Greek name. His YouTube channel is youtube.com/toptierarcade. All right, Steve, let's answer these questions here. So when I do my on-the-road videos, it seems like I'm not there very long. I just kind of go and disappear. Well, a lot of that is movie magic. I edit the videos, and I think it's such a way that, yeah, it looks like I get there, I go to the arcade, and I leave, because I mean, what am I going to show you? Like, me in the hotel, me eating dinner. So, most of these trips, like, you know, Puerto Rico, I was there for a week. You know, Chicago, I was there for a week. Visiting my family. So, no, that's not the case. Typically, I'm there on a vacation or seeing a friend or something like that, and sometimes for work. But no, I'm usually there for a while, and I do take in the sights, and I usually film some of that, and those will be the highlights in my videos when I show, like, you know, the scenery, the buildings, and, you know, that's usually on my, you know, on my free time, my downtime. You know, I'm just filming some B-roll, as the pros call it. No, I would never have a bachelor party or a corporate event in my basement. No, guys, this is my house. This is not a party hall. No, I would never do anything like that. And if you want to do a contest to name the name of the album or some of the song titles, I think we'd be open to that. I'm not really sure how we'd construct that contest, but And by the way, I did check out your channel there, Top Tier Arcade. You got a nice collection of fighting games. You got a Double Dragon. I saw your Miss Pac-Man. So guys, go check out his YouTube channel. YouTube.com/TopTierArcade. TOPTIER Arcade. And if you can figure out a way to do that contest, let me know. All right, so Samuel Otis. Hi John, I love your videos. I'm thinking about getting my first pinball machine, probably an old EM. What sorts of things must a first timer know when buying a pinball machine? Are there any common mistakes I should watch out for? What sort of maintenance do you do on your pinball machines? There's a lot of conflicting info out there, especially about waxing play fields. Thanks, Slim. And PS, what is this small monitor hanging from the ceiling above your Tron machine? All right, so any advice about pinballs? Well, I mean, truthfully, as far as EMs go, electromechanical pins, I don't have really any personal experience at all with those. I would like to get one. I'd like to figure them out. I've watched videos on that. You know, by the way, this old pinball, I know I've mentioned it before. It's a great series of videos. They're actually on DVD. You have to order them. Just Google, like, this old pinball. I've watched a bunch of the EM videos. Even though I don't have an EM machine, I still enjoyed it. But it looks like EMs, you know, there's just tons of switches and a lot of leaf switches, you know, a lot of cleaning of switches and taking things apart and putting that back together. I mean, as far as solid state pins, I can tell you one thing you definitely want to look out for is battery damage, because most of the boards have AA batteries on them, and they'll be stored with the batteries, and the batteries leak and they destroy the boards. So whenever you look at a pinball machine, the first thing you want to do is you want to basically remove the back glass and inspect the boards and make sure that the batteries have not leaked, because that's a big problem if they do. As far as maintenance goes, you know, as far as what I do to my pins, all I really do is I occasionally wax the play field. I use Carnauba car wax. I basically buy the liquid wax and I squirt it on my play field and wipe it down with a terry cloth and let it dry to a haze and then wipe it off. And you can also clean your playfields with Novus 2 is good, especially for getting, you know, like ball lines off and stuff. But really, I just use liquid Carnauba wax on my playfields. I do it maybe twice a year. And I change the rubbers when they get worn. You know, the flipper rubbers I change more often than any of the other ones. So I always make sure I have a bunch of flipper rubbers on hand. I like to use the red flipper rubbers and the white rubber band rubbers, because I've heard that the black and the red and the white are all different durometers of rubber. And the black is the hardest. I think the white rubber bands and the black rubber bands, the black ones are horrible, man, because they leave that black rubber dust all over the place. And if you ever see a pinball on location that has black rubbers and hasn't been cleaned forever, and the entire playfield is just black, I guarantee you, look at the rubbers, they're black, because that rubber dust gets on the ball and it just goes all over the playfield. So even if a game out of the factory came with black rubbers, I always change them. I always change them to white. I just like the white rubbers. I think they just look better. Now, actually, on my NBA Fast Break, I never changed them. I still have the blacks on there. But I will change those to white. I actually bought the white rubbers. But my Whirlwind's got white. My RFM has white. I think RFM originally had black. And then on the flipper rubbers, I always use red. I like the way those feel. And I don't know if this is an urban legend or what, but I believe it's true. The black ones are a harder rubber, and the balls really bounce off the flippers. And the red ones are a little more forgiving, a little more spongy, and I like those. I like how the red flipper rubbers feel, and I always use those. And that small monitor back there, that is a digital picture frame. Yeah, you want to see it? It's a junky thing. I bought that like on Amazon for like $30 or something. It's tiny. And I just threw a bunch of random crap on there. Bar open. Pretty stupid, right? So I just threw a bunch of random photos on there, and I went and grabbed like some images of neon signs. You know, look at Anheuser, thinking, oh, it looks like a neon sign back there. So this next one is from Josh Davis. Josh Davis says, I am restoring a Space Invaders Deluxe upright, and I have a couple of questions and would value your opinion. Number one, the plywood cabinet has sustained heavy water damage, and the particle board parts are shot. Repairing the old cabinet would require tearing it all apart and replacing the damaged boards, which is nearly all of the exterior ones, with new wood. Would it be worth building a new cabinet for this due to the extent of the damage? Number two, what are your thoughts on building a Taito control panel for it? I was thinking I could do that for my use and swap in the original if I were to sell it. I'm also thinking about putting the Braze multi-game kit in there for some variety. Thank you for getting me into this hobby, and keep up the good work. Josh from Arkansas. Josh, listen. Space Invaders Deluxe is a very common game, okay? It's a common game. So if the cabinet is just hosed, like beyond hosed, I would strongly consider finding another game, okay? Now maybe go on Craigslist or something and try to find a dead one, because if yours is good, if yours is working, find a dead Space Invaders maybe for $100 or something. You might get lucky, I think that, if I were in your situation, I would probably try to find a new cabinet, because that's a very common game, and those games usually sell for short money, and you might be able to find one broken somewhere. You're going to have to really look, though. It's not going to just fall in your lap. You're going to have to put the word out, maybe post on KLOV.com. Now, if you don't find one and you want to fix the wood, God, man, replacing the sides, that's going to be... I mean, that is just a straight-up plywood cabinet, right? And then you're going to have to stencil it. I don't know, man. I don't know if that game's worth all the effort. You could do it. You could replace the plywood sides and router it to the correct shape and put your T-molding groove in there and stencil the cabinet. It's going to be a lot of work, though. You could maybe pay someone to make a reproduction cabinet. I mean, you're going to be... That's going to be like $500, though. I mean... I think your best bet is looking for a dead game, a dead Space Invaders Deluxe. I would make a post on KLOV.com. And what are your thoughts on building a Taito control? I love that. I think the Taito version of Space Invaders is awesome because it has a joystick instead of buttons, and I think that's really cool. I actually would prefer to play Space Invaders that way. So I say go for it, man. Build a Taito control panel for it. And I think that'd be a lot of fun, and I also would strongly recommend the multi-game. The Braze multi-game kit is great. Definitely get that. All the Braze stuff is top-notch. So, Josh, I hope I helped you there. Okay, so the next one here is from Ron's Arcade. Hi, John. I'm usually in the background and don't log into YouTube or Google Plus, etc., but I've been enjoying your videos so much lately that I just wanted to drop you a line and ask you a few questions. About 18 months ago, after visiting a game event in Manchester, I decided to create my own arcade cabinet. But being a first attempt, I was never really 100% happy with it. So over the last few months, I've been giving it a good overhaul, and it's looking more like the real thing. I know you only really get involved in restoration of the genuine cabinets, and also realize you don't exactly love LCD/MAME cabinets, but I suppose it was all down to my technical know-how, or lack of it, and just wanting to get something built without too many headaches. And also, for me, space is at a premium. Anyway, thanks for your restoration videos, especially the excellent Journey restoration. I've picked up quite a few hints and ways of doing things I probably wouldn't have thought of for my own project. Just a couple of questions, if I may. If I did want to replace my LCD with a 19-inch CRT, what model would you recommend? And more generally, how would I connect it to a PC with a VGA connection? My card would also allow HDMI input. He says, enjoy the Carry On movie you got sent from Chucky Egg. I did laugh when I saw your look of bewilderment. They are a very British thing. I also look forward to your review of the ZX Spectrum. Specky, my first love. Thanks again, John. Regards, Rob. P.S. I have attached a couple of pics so you can see my cabinet changes. Any comments, good or bad, gracefully accepted. Completely redone inside. So second pick doesn't do it justice to the blood, sweat, and tears. Still not finished. All right, actually, Ron, why don't we show pictures right now of your arcade game? Let's show those. Pretty clean setup, Ron. I like it. For a scratch-built cabinet, it looks really good. I like that the control panel is clean. It has just the least amount of buttons that you need, and it has trackball. Because some of those main cabinets that are like flight decks of an aircraft carrier, they have like spinners and Robotron joysticks and Tron joysticks, and ugh, I liked what you did, man. Nice and clean, and for scratch built, you did a good job. Now, yeah, you could step up your game by installing a CRT, you know, a traditional monitor. If you wanted to install an arcade monitor, you have a couple of options to do so. Now, I'm assuming you already have your cabinet all wired up. I don't know if it's JAMA, though. Did you wire it JAMA? How did you do it? There's two ways to do it. Actually, first things first, though, your video card needs to output 15K, okay? That is the frequency that the arcade monitors are looking for, okay? And if your video card doesn't output 15K, it's not gonna sync, okay? And there's a couple ways to get your video card to output 15K. Well, one is you buy a new video card. There's a website called Ultimark, U-L-T-I-M-A-R-C. Google that. They're actually in the UK, great site. They sell a video card called Arcade VGA, okay? Arcade VGA, and it is a video card that outputs 15K, which again is what the arcade monitors are looking for. The other option, which is what I did with my MAME setup, is I picked up a cheap $30 GeForce video card, and I used a special driver that's called Soft 15. Google this, Soft 15, okay? It is a driver that works with a handful of video cards, most of them inexpensive. Again, my video card was like $30 on Amazon, okay? So I threw that GeForce in there, I installed the Soft 15 driver, and bam, now my video card is outputting 15K. Now we need to hook that up to the monitor, okay? And there's a couple ways to do that. And Ultimark, again, has the devices you need to do that, okay? Because the video cards are outputting VGA, right? And so Ultimark sells what's called a JPEG, and that's what I used, okay? And so you plug the VGA into the JPEG, and the JPEG is basically it's like a computer to JAMA adapter, essentially. And so my Miss Pac-Man, I converted it to JAMA with an adapter, and then I plugged the JPEG into that, and now all my controls and everything are wired into it. And then on the JPEG, there is also a header that you can then use to run the correct, you know, RGB and sync and ground that the arcade monitor wants, okay? Now, the JPEG would be fitting, assuming that your cabinet is wired JAMA. And it sounds like you already have it all wired up and it's done. So maybe the other option is Ultimark has something they call a video amplifier that kind of boosts the video signal out of a computer. And I actually used one in my Revenge from Mars. That is a little device and it does one function. It boosts the video signal. You basically plug VGA into it and then it has the headers, the RGB, the sync, and the ground that you would then run to the arcade monitor. So go to Ultimark and look at either the JPEG or the video amplifier, and then also figure out how you want to make your video card output 15K. And again, your two options there are Arcade VGA or Soft 15. And as far as monitors to get, well, I don't know. I mean, how do you plan on getting a monitor? Because My favorite monitor is the Wells Gardner 4900. If you want a vintage monitor, the Wells Gardner 4900 is good. The Electra Home G07 would be my next choice. So one of those two monitors are great. How are you gonna find that? Maybe make some posts locally, I don't know, or find a junk arcade game on Craigslist. You're in the UK, so whatever you have that is like Craigslist, those are the two choices I would say. Wells Gardner 4900 or Electra Home G07, or some of the newer monitors, you know, like the Betson Imperial. Do you guys have those over there? Or the Vision Pro, the Hap Vision Pro. Those are newer monitors. You know what's another good monitor is the Wells Gardner K7000. That's a decent monitor. The Wells Gardner K7000. So, I don't know. Did I help you there with the monitor choices? So, anyway, Ron, thanks. And cool cabinet, man. Nice job with the scratch build. Those are the kind of main machines I think I like the most. They don't harm anyone. It's a scratch build game. No original game was harmed. Okay, hi John. This is from Snake, or Chris, Panther UK. Hi John, great to hear that the channel is going from strength to strength. My question is, how long do you think it'll be until all of the PCB storage area moves to the garage so you can fit another 6 games in the basement? Also, could you plug a forum I moderate, which is a great source of help and information for people like myself without the room for a setup like yours and have gone the route of a MAME cabinet? If so, it's www.mameaddicts.com. Anyway, Happy New Year from England, Chris Panther. Actually, the last guy, Ron, you might want to go on his site. He's in the UK. Mameaddicts.com, because Chris here is in the UK. Maybe you guys can get together and he can help you put a CRT in your MAME cabinet. So there you go, Chris. We plugged your site. And you know what, guys? I need to have that area over there. I need to have some storage in this house because the basement here used to be our storage area, and the arcade has taken over that. And so I need to have something over there that is still kind of basement-y. Because, you know, the washer and dryer over there, the furnace, and then I've got some shelving with junk on it. So I've thought about it. I've thought about pushing the arcade back, and I kind of calculated that I might only gain room for maybe one more or two more games. I don't know. It's probably not worth it. So for now, this is the basement. Okay. Last one here from Zero. Hi, John. Loving all the extra videos. Thanks. I have been a diehard fan of the channel since the John's Arcade Impossible episode. Haven't missed an episode and have to watch all of the previous ones. I have a couple of questions. One, are there any games you are considering getting rid of to make room for new additions? Two, would it be possible, would a possible good solution to the space issue, keeping your lineup fresh, be to occasionally rotate games from the garage to the basement and vice versa? I've thought of that. Are there any games you know already that you have to have in 2015? Keep up the awesome shows and have a happy new year. Rick Beebe from Binghamton, New York. All right, Rick. Well, are there any games I'm considering getting rid of? I don't know. It's getting tough, guys. I like all these games. I mean, the only game that I think the only game I would consider right now is Gyrus, and I don't think it's a popular choice. So I don't know what to do. I'm so out of room. And I got that jump bug in the garage, and I have a Donkey Kong 3 that's not down here. That's at a friend's house. Because that was my move. Because the Donkey Kong 3, I didn't want to sell it because I liked it. I wanted it, and I need to have a Donkey Kong 3. So I let a friend borrow it. It's in his basement. I'm at a loss as to what game leaves, because I'm gonna need to make room down here because Quantum is coming down. I thought about the dartboard. I thought about actually not selling the dartboard, moving that to the garage, bringing another game down here, and seeing how I feel about the dartboard missing. And the Gyrus, I have considered that. I thought about the track and field, but I changed my mind. After that, it gets impossible. It's absolutely impossible, you know, looking around, like, what could leave? I don't know, man. I mean, everything that... Maybe the Outrun. That's a small game in the corner, though. You know what? The R run could go. I'm not really attached to that. I have to admit, because I suck at it. I cannot finish that game. I don't know what. All right. So the Outrun, the Gyrus, that's it. I think that's it. No, there's nothing else that I would get rid of. I think. And are there any games you know already that you have? You know, in 2015, I'm gonna be looking for some oddball stuff. I don't know what it is. I'll know it when it comes up for sale. Like a Nintendo Sheriff. You know, I gotta have that. If I can find a Nintendo Sheriff, I will. That is the coolest thing in the freaking world. And I need to be quiet about it. I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to hype it up and then not be able to find one because people are looking for it. But Nintendo Sheriff is one. You know, we got to build the Quantum, the Baby Pack, of course. You know, you guys have heard me talking about Baby Pac-Man, and we saw that one at Pin Wizard. I don't think Sarah would come down, to be honest. She's pretty hardcore with the prices. Maybe, Sarah. Maybe this video. What do you think? Hook Johnny up? I don't know. We'll see, Rick. Anyway, that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you liked the road trip to Pinball Wizard Arcade in Pelham, New Hampshire. Again, if you're going to Funspot, man, make a stop there on the way. You should, because it's a great place. It's one of the better arcades I went to this year. I'll say that. Just because of the sheer variety. Tons of pinballs, tons of vids, one building. Win. Anyway, guys, I release new videos on Sundays and sometimes in between. This is one of those in-between videos because I am on a roll right now with the holiday break, releasing videos as often as I can, trying to do one or two a day. Really, one is realistic, sometimes two. Well, no, this is going to be on the heels of the Donkey Kong video. And then we have to start fixing some stuff down here because I got an opto out on the Revenge from Mars, 720 monitors hosed, the Tempest is flaking out over there. Stuff is breaking right now, man. And that sound is not working on that Mr. Duke cartridge. What's up? I bet you I reseat that cartridge if fixes it. We'll see. Anyway, if you like these videos, guys, please click the subscribe button. If you made it to the end here and you've never subscribed, come on. You must like it. Go ahead, click subscribe. Because, you know, we're almost at 14,500 subscribers. I was hoping to get to 15,000 by the end of the year. We didn't do it. Because, you know, it's New Year's Eve, guys, by the way. Happy New Year. You guys are watching us in the New Year. We didn't hit 15,000 this year. Close. I bet you we'll hit it in January. Knock on wood or whatever. So anyway, if you like the videos, make sure you like and share and all that stuff. Let's grow the channel. And by the way, if you guys like the music in the video, actually the music in the video today is by my band, The Killscreens. Not on this album, though. We have a SoundCloud page. If you go to soundcloud.com/TheKillscreens, soundcloud.com/TheKillscreens, I've got a ton of music, work in progress stuff, and the songs in this video are those. And those songs you can download for free. You can go on SoundCloud and get them all for free. There's download buttons on pretty much every song. They're all work in progress. I play a lot of those in the videos. And I also play the stuff from our album, The Killscreens Science Fiction Movie. That's right, the band is called The Killscreens, the album Science Fiction Movie. The album, you can buy the physical CD on Amazon and CD Baby. They're actually sold out right now. I need to send them new inventory. You can also get the MP3 album on Amazon, iTunes, and you can stream it for free if you are a Spotify member. So go on Spotify and search for The Killscreens and do the same on Amazon and iTunes. And that's going to be about it for this video, guys. Check out my podcast, Video Game Outsiders at videogameoutsiders.com and Arcade Outsiders at arcadeoutsiders.com. If you guys like the videos, consider supporting me. Go on my YouTube channel. There's a support button and whatever. Just do that stuff because I want to get a wireless microphone. We got about 2/3 of the funds, so we're not there yet. So, all right, guys, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Later and bye.